I'm pretty sure you already have a fun game, but can you play it with other people? If not, this tutorial is right for you. We're gonna take this simple third-person project, turn it into a multiplayer game, and talk about the different solutions on how to implement multiplayer. At first, you need to decide if you want dedicated servers to host your game, which is more costly, but the players can cheat or modify the game. This approach is suitable if you are making a competitive game. The other solution is peer-to-peer based, where one player hosts the game and acts as the server and the client. There are also two options to consider. Either everything is server authoritative, means the server, or in this scenario the host moves all the players and does all the logic while the client sends him the input. Or the other option that I'm showing you, where every player moves their character themselves and the position of the players then gets synchronized. This allows for a smoother gameplay, despite that it's easier to cheat, but it should be enough for most casual games. That said, let's start by adding the netcode for game objects package for the general multiplayer functionality and multiplayer play mode for opening more instances of our game. This package is only available on Unity 2023 or higher, so if you have an older version, I would upgrade that. Make a new empty game object, give him the network manager component and select the Unity transport. If you're making your game with the Steam API, you would select the Steam transport. Next, we need to connect the start host and start client functions to a UI with a simple script and two buttons, but nothing would work now. We first need to make a prefab of our player and delete it in the scene. Then put the player as the network manager and add it to the network prefab list. We also need to add a network object and a network transform to our player, but the normal network transform is server authoritative and only the server can move it, like in the other method previously mentioned. Therefore, we need to create a new script called ClientNetworkTransform. We could get it directly from the Unity documentation, but it's not that hard to write. If you use this, the client can directly modify the position of their player. Make sure to only check the variables you want to sync, because we don't want to send unnecessary data. We also need to change a bit in our player script. First, we're going to change it from a mono behavior to a network behavior. Then we move all the code from the start method into the onNetworkSpawn. There we check if we are the owner of the player, and if we are not, we are going to deactivate the camera and the cinema machine free look camera, because we don't want to have more than one camera in our scene. And most importantly, we're gonna check if we are the owner in the update method, so we can only move the player if we are the owner. If you want, you can also create a network variable on the script where you can regulate the read and write permissions. This can be used, for example, as an integer to represent the health of the player. Lastly, on our player mesh with an animator, we need to add a network animator, but like with the transform, the normal network animator won't work. We need to create our own client network animator, where we again override the on is server authoritative method, and now in the client can modify its animator. When we add this to our player mesh and drag the animator inside, all the animations should be synced. Now when we go into the multiplayer play tools and create a new instance of our game, we can host the game in one window and join as a client on the other one. Now everything should be perfectly synced, and voila, your game is now multiplayer. You can expand further on this logic with Unity Relay, another package that's part of the Unity gaming services, to easily connect players with each other if you are having your game on more platforms than Steam and you want to have crossplay between them. Thanks for watching, and I wish you all a great day.